Okay, maybe we can start. My talk today actually is out of schedule because we have to substitute today's speaker. I think that we with Yasmina Georgievich from University of Oslo. Almost finish our work, so I can present it to you. The main problem which we will discuss today is the Clark representation of the random measure. So I will have two objects. The first one is, for example, mu is a random measure. And what is important now that this is a really random measure in a sense that we randomly take probability measure. This is not a martingale measure or something. So I will have, for example, RD with the usual sigma field. I have a space of all probability measures. On RD. Usually we can equip this space with some good distance, for example, Wasserstein distance, gamma is distance. Then one can consider Borel sigma field. So I can consider such measured space. And for me, mu is a random element. Random element in M, in the space. This is the first object. The second object is much more familiar for us. This is a standard Wiener process. So I will suppose that we have a standard Wiener, one-dimensional Wiener process, WT, on the interval 0, 1. Finally, I will unite these two objects together and suppose that mu is measured. Which respect to W on this interval. The problem which we will discuss is following. Under this assumption, I can take any function, any test function phi, for example, from C0 on RD, this zero means that it has a compact support. And I can consider the random variable. I will denote it in the following way. This is just integral from the function phi against mu. Due to this assumption, one can say that this random variable is also measured with respect to W. Moreover, a function phi is a bounded function. Mu is a random probability measure. So one can say that this is L2 random variable measure with respect to W. Consequently, it has Clark representation. What does it mean? It means that this random variable phi mu can be uniquely represented as the following. I will write here mu with bar plus the integral from 0 to 1, and here r phi t dwt. Here, what does mean bar? It means the expectation of it is not difficult to check that this expectation can be taken can be put inside, and the expectation of our random measure is gain measure. So we will pay attention to the second term of this decomposition. One can easily verify that R is linear with respect to phi. So if we consider A1, phi1 plus A2, phi2, T, then for almost all T and for almost all omega, we will have the equality. The question is, can we say that this R phi can be expressed as follows? R phi T is equal to phi kappa T, where kappa is a random signed measure. Random in a sense which I said before. So despite that we discuss only Wasserstein distance on the probability measures on RD, one can equip with topology the space of all signed measure of finite signed measures of finite variation on RD. So one can consider the Borel sigma field in this set of all signed measures and consider random elements. So the question is whether this R phi, which is a linear functional with respect to phi, be a really good functional with respect to phi. And in general, it occurs that with probability which is close to one, the answer is no. I will say what does it mean. This question is more or less related and can be discussed with such general picture. Suppose that we have Banach space. B is a real Banach space. And suppose that we have the same problem here. namely, that we consider the psi is a random element. In B, with finite random finite second moment of the norm, and we consider again, at least we try to consider again its Clark representation. What I mean, take F from B star. And then consider the random variable f applied to psi. Due to this condition, it will be again square integrate random variable. And what we will have that it must have a representation like this one. F psi is equal again f, here is psi bar. Under this condition, psi has Bochner integral, and here is this integral, and plus integral from 0 to 1. Here is R F D D W T. And one can ask the same question as previously. Can we say that RFT will be equal to F from some kappa T, where kappa T is a random element in B. Actually, one can see that our problem is related to this very closely. For example, if we consider signed measures with the norm variation, only what we lose separability. As the subspace of such measures, one can consider space L1 small. So we actually need this case, because everybody understands that this L1 can be embedded in the space of signed measures. This is a general question, and after I spent some time. Firstly, I tried to prove positive statement, then tried to build a counter example in this space, and finally I found in the literature a lot on this subject, and it occurs that in 2008 two people from Netherlands, Nielsen, I think, and Nieren. They proved positive statement, but positive statement is valid only for B, which has the so-called UMD property. And let me explain what is this, and then it is clear that it is real. UMD property, this is a short name for unconditional martingale difference property. What does it mean? UMD property. It means that It means that if we have a martingale difference d1, dn, this is martingale difference in B, one can consider the following new martingale difference in a good sense. So I suppose that we have all moments of the norm, so in both sense. Then one can consider new sequence epsilon 1, which is equal plus minus 1 epsilon n, which is equal plus minus 1. This unconditional martingale difference property means that for it was introduced for fixed p greater than 1, but then it was verified that it holds then for all p greater than 1, that there exists c which belongs on which depends only on p, not depend on n, such that the expectation, the norm, the sum from k equal 1 to n epsilon k dk p less cp, then expectation of the norm k equal 1 to n dk without signs.
Random variables, are epsilons random variables or just numbers, arbitrary?
Just numbers, but here is C, which does not depend on epsilon. So one can now begin to play. So actually this was done in the work of these two guys. It follows from here that one can take it evidently independent and next one predictable. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So these are two steps which can be done, and then one can understand that some martingales related to the elements from B have good estimations. Have good estimations which can be obtained from the integrands. And actually, this was a key to the Clark representation. Under this UMT condition, these authors, by the way, not only these authors, but parallelly with them, maybe 2006, 2008, there are several papers by Moshe Zakai with co-authors. They were able to prove that this Clark representation holds with the integrand again from B. After this, one can check book of PGE. This book is like this one, Martingales in Banach space, and verify that UMT property has all LP space for P which is greater than 1, but not L1. Actually it is very closely related to the convexity of the norm. In this case, it does not hold. From this point of view, it is reasonable that we don't ask about the Clark representation for arbitrary random mesh. But in our talk, we are looking for Clark representation for random measures which are not so rich. And actually, we will consider random measures which arise when we solve the equation with interaction. So I will consider the equation with interaction of the following type: dxut is equal a xut mu t t plus b xut dwt. Here, I suppose that x, you start from every point of the space, and that we have initial distribution, which is non-random. It's just probability measure on the RD, and that mu zero under the flow moves to mu t. So the infinitesimal increment of the position of the particle depends on the noise and depends on the its position at the moment of the time and on the mass distribution of all particles.
Do you have mu t instead of b?
You see, I will explain why I am not considering here just actually this is a plan. We will suppose to do this in the future. Here the infinite number of inner processes and put mu inside of p also. But at the moment, actually we have some technical troubles with this. So I do what I can do. Yeah. Why I am considering such kind of measures? Because from the point of view of its structure, they are not very rich. Here is the structure. This is the one motivation. Another one came from Yasmina because she is a specialist in the forward-backward stochastic differential equation, and we suppose to consider forward-backward stochastic differential equation with interaction. So the one step when we construct such kind of equation, we need Clark representation for our measurement, which arise here. So there are two reasons just to see what will happen if we consider not general random measure, where we have no hope to have Clark representation with good integrand, but of such. Why we have now positive expectation? Because there is Clark-O'Connor formula. Let me recall you. This formula express integrand in the Clark representation in terms of Malliavin derivative. So if we have a random variable alpha such that there exists stochastic derivative of alpha, then one can check that the following relation holds. Alpha is equal to expectation of alpha plus integral from zero to one. And here is expectation of derivative of alpha at t, f with respect to sigma field generated by W, and here is the dWt. Here is t, and it must be note that d alpha is a random function in L201 space with the finite second moment. So actually for every t, we don't know what is this, but this operation can be defined on the set of random functions. It is properly defined and give us the function which can be integrated against dw in Itô sense. So this is Itô integral, and we know that Clark representation and the finite second moment is unique. So this is actually this is the answer. Now let's came back to our expression. What we will have? We have the following. We have switch the marker. We have the random variable alpha in our case is phi mu t, and due to the definition of the equation, this interaction, it can be expressed as integral. Let's write it as follows. And here is phi x u t mu zero du. Here is non-random measure. So one can expect that if we have a good function phi here, then one can try to find stochastic derivative of x, yes? Then apply the formula as follows. Then d of phi mu t the point s, I must say that s now is less or equal than t, will be equal to integral with respect to rd, phi, here is phi prime x ut, and here is d x ut s, and then mu zero du. At this formula, yeah, from this point of view, one can see what we really need to in order to say that Clark representation for mu t consists of the process of finite measures. We need several things. First of all, we of course need this one. Yes. Second one, you see here phi prime, even in this situation. What we will do? Actually, if we if we consider this integral, it is bad from the point of view of representation of integral with respect to phi. But you remember this one, and we will do following. We will consider expectation of this phi prime multiplied by dx. I will write in details later, with respect to ft, with respect to ft. And then if we will have a good representation of x, if we will have a good representation of x, for example, forget for a moment. And here we have.
Do we take conditional expectation with respect to f of t or f of s?
F of t. Right now. But in the explanation, here you are right. We have here fs. And for example, forget for a moment about stochastic derivative. Then you have this one. And then one can think that x has also a density, conditional density, when we consider it starting at, from the moment s. But not only x, and here is the question, because in the equation, this interaction, this X is not a Markovian at all. So we need to consider everyone fixed at the moment S, but still we can ask, there exist?
I don't see S in the last formula on the right hand side.
Because you see, I just wrote the representation for stochastic derivative of this integral. Yes. Then when we will go further, you will see S inside.
But I see some symbol which I cannot understand. The last symbol.
Here is S.
Yes.
Here is S.
Ah, this is S. Ah,
yes,
okay.
Yes.
So
we have a random variable, and its derivative depend on the additional time variable. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Maybe if you replace t small by one and s by t, you'll get the same indexes as in Clark O'Connor formula. Now here is another t.
Yes. Of course, when I will speak about representation of mu one, then we will do this. You are right. So the question is, there exists density for x u t. And actually, we already know, this is a well-known fact, that these two questions are very closely related. And let me recall that for equation with interaction, maybe Takashi Komatsu was the first who discussed the existence of the density in terms of Malliavin derivative. And let me say what he did. By the way, in our journal, Theory of Stochastic Processes, and he considered the equation of the kind dxut is equal to, here is a specification of the coefficient A. You remember, I began with the coefficient of the kind x mu. This is the coefficient of the general kind. And we already know that it can include terms which are responsible about the pairwise interaction or multiple interaction between the different particles which start from different points. So he used the following, and here is a two from x u t x v t, and here is mu zero dv dt. And you say, you see, this is the same as before, because this is just a change of variables formula, and plus b of x
integral
ut, here is the sum from k equal 1 to n b of x ut bk. And here is Stratonovich dwkt. In this case, he was able to prove that there exists the stochastic derivative of the solution to equation for with interaction there exists dxut. And it has some exponential moments. Due to this, he was able to prove that there exists density with with exponential moments of the norm, and then there exists density. But let me say to you that for us, only existence of the density is not enough. And I will explain in a minute why. Actually, it is expectable because you remember we have this phi prime multiplied on something. So what we need? We need to make integration by parts. From this point of view, we need the smooth density. Okay, it can be. It can be extracted from there. But after this, we need additional integration. So we also need estimations on the density. And I must say that in the article of Komatsu, there are no estimations for the probability density of the solution X. So let me now came to our consideration. But the idea is already given. So what we did, we will consider first the stochastic derivative of X, then its representation, and try to say that it has good density. So I will consider partial case of the equation restriction. Actually, unfortunately, this is what we can do up to this moment. It will be one dimensional case. R here A2 D mu zero dv dt plus dwt. You see, here is very poor equation, but nevertheless, now one can check that if you suppose that if you denote eta s t, this is the st du t, and this will be a stochastic derivative of x u t at the time s, then one can check that this stochastic derivative satisfy a good good equation. It can be obtained just formally differentiating everything, and I must just note that this guy gives us one at the point t equal to s. So for eta s u t, we have the following equation: is equal to one plus, and then two terms from there. R A2 prime. Here we must be careful because here we have two coordinates and we will do differentiation with respect both of them. X U T, X V T, and then eta S u t mu zero dv dt plus the next term, the integral from r a prime to two, here is x u t x v t, and here is eta s vt mu zero dv dt the solve. So from this point of view, it's not bad equation. And if you suppose that these derivatives of our kernel A are bounded, then this equation has a solution. Moreover, one can check that in this case, this solution is also bounded. It is important. So from this point of view, one can say that now stochastic derivative of our solution
Something is wrong in your equation. There must be differential in the left-hand side or integral or not. So S is less than T.
From this one, it gives one. It gives one. Yeah. It gives one. You see, because when you are greater than in the integral form, what is it? This is just integral from zero to t dw.
No, I mean that there should be differential in the left hand side.
Here
or integral with respect to dt in the right hand.
Oh yes, 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 you are right. I just put dt. Yes, here is integral from zero to t. Let's put here t prime. It's much better to do this, of course, because this is I already write it in this form. Yes, yes, you are right. T prime, t prime. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we will have the statement that this stochastic derivative exists. And now let's think about density. And here I use a lemma, which is due to Noala and. It is from his book on Malliavin Calculus. This Malliavin Calculus was application to finance. And in this book, when he began consider the conditions for the existence of the density, he considered case of such guy. Suppose that we have such integral, such representation, this process eta t, which has a representation like this one, this integral some x zero plus integral from zero to t from u s d w s, and suppose that u is bounded, has enough stochastic derivative, two stochastic derivative, and minus eight moment of stochastic derivative is good. In this case, he was able to prove the density estimation for this eta. Namely for eta, we have the full estimation here that density of eta satisfy Gaussian estimation. This is some constant square root of t. And here is minus x square divided also by some constant c1, c2. In this case, x u t, if you wrote here in integral form, have additional term, and plus u. But this guy is bounded, it has enough stochastic derivatives. And all estimations from here can be rewritten. For example, from here he get this one. It is estimation of the tail probability for such Martingale. But you see, this bounded things. So estimation for the tape probability remains the same on the bounded interval. We consider t from integral 0 t. one can check that we will have not only probability density in our case, but we will have a good estimation. Now let's come back to our Clark-O'Connor formula.
And do we need smoothness of density?
And it is there also. I need it. Now let's consider what we need. Actually, our R phi, I will not repeat all formulas. But I just write R phi of t is equal to here will be the integral, with respect to R, phi prime of x ut, u1, here is one already, u1. Here is this guy, eta t, here is u1, and mu0 du, yes. And then we have a conditional expectation which respect to f wt. Here is our representation. What we need, to integration by part formula. So what we can do, just put here the equation for eta. And it will be equal, and at this case, we will have three different terms. The first one, expectation, here is integral r, here is phi prime, x, u1, here is just one. You remember equation for eta t, start from one. Here is mu zero du, and here is conditional expectation with respect ftw. And this term is good for us because what we can do, we can put it here, and here happens exactly what we discussed, because if we fix t, which is less than one, and at this moment we fix everything but this sigma field contains everything, contains mu t, for example, then this guy will have density, conditional density, and this conditional density is smooth, as Andrey mentioned. So one can do integration by part, and it turns finally after integration by part in integration of phi, which is against some signed measure. So this term is good, and now let's go to the next terms, and let me write it in. What we will have here? We will have here the integral from t to 1, integral with respect to r, r prime to 1, x u s And here eta t u s, that is mu zero d v and d s, then plus more or less the same, just I will write the last term. The last term will eta t from v, eta t v s d, and here we have mu zero dv and then ds. And then we have to take again conditional expectation with respect to FTW. My proposition, what to do with this one? You see, here several bad terms. This bad terms arise due to this eta here. But you remember equation for eta. And if we suppose that, and we already did this, that A has bounded derivative, then this equation can be solved by iteration method. And then I will have here convergence series, which consists of multiple integrals from such kernels. Yes? And then I will have kernels, and I will have here just one phi prime. So when I will have kernel, excuse me,
you have xvs, and you, when you consider condition,
yes, xv and xu does not matter because xv is integrated with respect to mu zero every time. So we will have, of course, multiple integrals with respect to time variable, with respect to space variable. But nevertheless, we will have the guys like this one. Here is a lot of integrals. This is important. Integral with respect to time simplex. And here is, for example, n. Here is some kernel like b and a lot of x inside. Yeah. And here is also mu dv for curtains, dv j, for example, mu zero dv j, for example. But after all of these things, finally we will have phi prime from x u one. Yes, and the biggest time variable here is tn, which is less than one. Yeah.
My question was, how do you integrate by parts? Because you have XUS and XVS, and we don't know if this pair about density of the pair.
Yes. Actually, I will not need this. I just, this is like a trick, because what I said that this X inside of the kernel has time variables up to the moment tn. You remember, this is a simplex with respect to the time.
Okay.
And the last one is tn. But we consider this. We consider this at the point one. You see? So before I will take the conditional expectation, this one, I will take this Tn. And then I need only one time integration by part. And I can do this. I already will have this measure. And you remember estimation on the density and on the derivative of the density, if you check the Nolar book, then you can see that one can integrate by part, and this is bounded kernel. You see, we have a very strong condition on our coefficients. Maybe it can be released, and I hope that in the future we will release this this condition, but now it is bounded. So after integration, everything gives you like t in some good power. So you can integrate just one time, integrate by part, and then take a conditional expectation. You already will have some random measure, and you just take its conditional expectation. Actually, this is all what I wanted to say. Like a resume of our talk, we can say the following: that we for equation with interaction of the such simple kind, dxut equal integral a to xut xvt dt plus dwt, we know that mu, which is mu t is equal mu zero x, excuse me, here is mu zero dv x t minus one, then we can say that mu one has Clark representation like mu bar plus integral from zero to one kappa t dwt, where kappa is a measure, a signed measure. as I said, in general case, we have no hope to have such representation, but for pure random measures of pure structure, we can do this. Yeah? That's all what I wanted to say today. Thank you for attention. Maybe somebody have questions or comments.
What happens if mu zero is a discrete measure, then you have just some fixed points with masses?
Yes.
And is it possible to find Clark representation, or maybe the your statement will be simplified?
Yes, sure. Like for one, suppose we have a system, because we remember that for heavy particles we have a closed system, we already get the diffusion process, and for the for diffusion process we can just have this representation, because for every x we have it, so we can do this. Yeah.
No, I meant maybe there is some another nice formula.
You see, yes, it will. I tried to go to the limit from this representation, but I was not succeed. Maybe it was because of at those time I considered general coefficient, and it was hard to check, because you see what happened. I started with such reason, but maybe I was wrong with consideration of this, let me switch it, general guy u mu, because even you have a good discrete measure mu zero is like this one, k equal 1 to n pk delta uk. Then what we will have here? You will have just such function, and here we have sum from k and pk d delta ykt, here is our coordinates of our diffusion process. You have, maybe at those time, I was confused because when you have such a general coefficient, it was hard to me to understand what happened here. So this was the reason why I was going to such coefficient. After this, I just recall that somebody already calculated stochastic derivative. It was Komatsu. I just take his article. Yeah. So maybe this was the reason why I choose this way. Maybe you are right, and this way also can be mastered, and even for general coefficient. But at the moment, I have such picture.
Okay, I see. Thank you.
Thank you. Maybe some other comments?
I would like to ask one question. What does it mean, two, index two?
This is, Nikolai Ivanovich, this is, I think, important indices, because you see, as I mentioned, this guy, general coefficient, which contains u and mu, sometimes, this is also not very general case, but can be expressed as follows. This is a sum from k equal 2 to infinity. Here is the multiple integral k, k minus 1. And here is a k x u t x v 1 t x v 2 t and so on. So this is like potential of the interaction between k particles. So this was the reason why I put, why I hold these two there in index.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Maybe some other questions?
In your last, in your Clark representation, cap of T is a signed measure which is adapted to W, yes?
Exactly. This was the aim, yeah.
Is there some hope to continue this Clark representation to get some kind of Krylov-Veretennikov?
You know, maybe Nina remember this very well, because we also tried to check this Krylov-Veretennikov, and actually maybe she became to be very angry about me 2 months ago, because I just asked it. Can you explain me what is in this Krylov-Veretennikov expansion will be action of the operator related to diffusion part on the semi-group on measures? You see? So there are some even technical problems to write it correctly.
But in the form it is very similar, yes?
Yeah, from the formal, yes, see what happens. We expect that if we have f from mu t, yeah, it will be equal like this one. It will be equal to expectation plus the sum of these integrals, delta kt, and inside of integrals we have such things, t1, then b, formally it looks like this, t21 minus t and so on, but what is this? This is tt is a semi-group on measures. Yes, and so on. B, what is B? This is an operator of differentiation. Even in this simple case, B must be like D with respect to du lifted on the meshes. And in this case, we have to think why it is good. Yes? Actually, Andrey Pilipenko asked me a question about discrete approximation. We already tried it there. And see what happened. We have to understand the expression of this semigroup, even for the discrete measures on such kind of functions. And actually, there are a lot of technical problems there. I think that it can be mastered to, again, as a discrete approximation. But after all these attempts, we found this Clark-O'Connor formula for X, and will be, and, it was good for us, yeah? So maybe, again, we also thought about these things and spent some time. Maybe it can be done. But right now, I cannot say precise formula here. Some other questions, please.
And assume that a measure mu zero is absolute continuous. Will the proof be easier in this case?
Yes, I think so. At least again for such case, because in this case we can get semi-linear partial stochastic differential equation for this density, for the density. Then one can one can find in the Noalar and Pardou articles that this density has stochastic derivative. Maybe from this point of view it can be easily calculated Clark-O'Connor representation. I think that maybe in this case it can be simplified. But still, we have to do some work. Because the equation will be not very good. It will be semi-linear. So again, we must to have some conditions as the coefficients when it has stochastic derivative and so on. So by the way, in this simple case, I have no supposition on whether mu zero is discrete or not. It works in general. Oh, Andrey, I cannot hear you.
If mu zero is absolute continuous, you may make a change of variables and then integrate by parts with respect to u. Without stochastic derivatives, and then take.
Yes, I can do this, but inside you will have determinant or derivative of X, space derivative of X. Then, when you use Clark-O'Connor formula, you also have some estimation on X in order to say that again this is a good stochastic density. Yeah. In this case, it is so. Yeah.
And you assume that A is twice differentiable.
I assume now I need only one time differentiability of A, but I need that all these derivatives are continuous and bounded.
Yeah. But you need a smoothness of density. Yes.
Yes, you're right. We have to estimate second derivative. So I need second derivative. Also, they are bounded. Yeah, you're right. Okay.
Thanks.
Some other questions? Yeah. Okay, if there are no any questions, then we will finish the work of our seminar for this semester. Thanks everybody, and I must say that two things. The first is just boring thing that I invite everybody to send application for the talk for the next semester to Georgi Ryabov. This is technical things. And a good thing is that New Year is coming. So Happy New Year, everybody. Bye.
Happy.